Light them up. Safety on. Book it. Let's go. Look left, look right. Always be scanning. This is where you're going to use the AK and the pistol though. Ground your gun, safety on. Grab that Glock. Light it up until I say stop. Fast as you can. Slow down, stop. Ooh, what do we have here? Wow. Clear that malfunction. Pop your mag out. Wow, Glocks have problems too.
Dude, it's cold.
15 degrees.
No excuses. I will not make any excuses. Okay, now listen to me. I'm trying to put you under pressure. Shoot as fast as you can. That's kind of setting you up a little bit.
Okay.
Where you're not getting a good trigger press, you're not breathing good. Okay. Don't ever get rushed. You gotta have fundamentals. So cleansing breath right now. Get that sight picture. Maintain it. Fire when ready. Look at that, dude. That's a TAC ammo. I wonder if it's underpowered or something.
That's what I started thinking.
I bet you it's the ammunition.
I'll shoot my 19.
What kind of ammo do you have in it?
Self-defense, but you can shoot it.
Okay, throw it out there.
I just have PMC 45 for the 21.
Okay, do that.
Yeah.
But where is it?
In the truck?
No, too far away. All right, let's go. Glock 19, actually. Okay, slow down. Let me see you take a deep breath and hold it. Breathe out about halfway. Slow trigger press. There you go. Okay, grab the gun. Grab that AK. Shoot till I say stop. Behind you. Quick. Don't move up on it. Where are you going, dude? It's an SGL 21 with a Troy rail on it. You suck. Safety on. Grab your other gun. Let's go. Playtime's over. Hey, I want some funny lines out of both of you guys.
Okay.
Funny lines. I'm carrying the show here, so let's go. Doodle, get with it. Start running. Up, two, three, four. Piece of cake, Sean. Look left, look right. Oh, I see a little glow thing in the road. That must mean you're getting ready to get shot. Right side! 10 shots as fast as you can. Where's that cleansing breath? Kneeling. Your lower target that way. Suck less.
It's only 50 yards.
That's only 60 yards, dude. Behind you. Is there a target out there or no? Maybe not. Okay, keep running down the road, sorry. Light it up. Fast as you can. 10 shots. Stop. Shooter sticks, deploy. Jardine.
Got it.
Down.
Get him high. Get in the glass. See what height you need. Lock it in. Grab that fore end. Bring that finger on and lock it in and make it real stable. Got it?
Got it.
Good cleansing breath. Let me hear it. Good. A little more magnification right about there. There you go. Reload. I want 5 more out of there. Didn't go in all the way, did it? You're right there. Okay, go. Safety on.
All hits with the sticks. Good job.
Hey, nice.
Fuck it!
Okay, stop. You carry these.
Yeah.
Put them beside the gun, just like this.
Okay.
And that's how you're going to carry.
Okay.
That way, if you need to shoot, your trigger finger's unobstructed. These go right down the trigger guard. Piece of cake.
Nice.
Let's go. Okay, we're running. We're not running fast. Slow down a little bit. Nice slow jog. Look left, look right the whole time. Future drills, we may have pop-up targets come out of nowhere.
Remember, jazz hands get more circulation than each of your fingers. I just got this full-on mini walk over here.
Good job, good job. Show him that cone, that's where he's going. Right up to the cone. Shoot. Down on your knees. Down, down, down. Russ, breathe, man. Rest. Get your shooting sticks together, but rest and relax. If we're taking rounds, where would we be resting? Like that?
Or
like this?
Laying down.
Laying down. So no one sees us, right?
Hey.
All right, so while you get your sticks, go ahead and look through the glass. We'll work your zero out for you.
Yeah, that's correct. You're doing it right.
So there's a target there.
That's the cone we're looking at right now. We put a cone by it.
Because I see a cone, the truck, and a cone.
The one on the left, forget about. Don't even look at that one. The target is right in the light.
It is?
That one's a valley target. Yeah, the light died, so.
I don't know if you can see it. You can stop filming for now. Just close the lid.
All right.
Do you see it?
I still see a cone.
Okay, look to the left of the cone, you might see that target. Our flashlight died on one of the targets, and it's pretty much impossible to see with the snow. If you don't see it, don't worry about it.
No. Is it the lights on it right now?
Never mind. Blow it off. Let's go. Tree.
So we're going to ride through that.
Yards night, snowing. About 20 degrees. One more shot. Kind of tough, huh?
Yeah.
All right, safety on. Safety on. Everybody, please press. All right, slow jog. Last stage.
All right, where are we headed?
Yeah, so straight pass. Just jog straight. This way, dude. Follow me. Safety's on, right?
Safety's on.
Almost wrapping it up. Soldier drill. Sean the TMP here. Now shooting the Stag AR 3G. Dial down your magnification if you need to get on it first.
Yeah.
So you can find it.
There we go.
Change guns, because we know the zero of this one. Do you see it?
Yep.
Now dial up once you're on it.
Yeah.
Don't breathe in the scope. Yards on this stage. Night, snowing, 20 degrees, SPR.
That's me, that was a bad squeeze.
Okay, safety on. We're gonna move closer. It jammed. Clear it. Okay, when you do, yeah, you're doing fine. Just keep doing it. I think it's the ammo, dude.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah.
It's just underpowered for this cold weather.
Yeah.
I could have dialed the gas system up, but I didn't do it.
Am I hitting it? Yep, that's a hit.
Yep, you're on it.
Hammer him.
Rail on it.
I got dialed up too much now.
If it's blurry,
there we go.
Let's change you right here. Hang on a second. So let's go right about here. Is that more in focus?
Yeah, that's a
little bit. Change this left knob until you're in focus on the target. Okay. Is that working?
Yeah. Yep. Right there. Nice. Oh, that's beautiful. That's good shooting.
Nice job, dude. Wanted you to end strong.
Yeah.
So is it a little bit easier at shorter range?
Much easier. Much easier. Yeah.
I gotta tell you, that 400 yard shot at night is a butt kicker.
Dude, you can't
see. It ain't Sean. I was having trouble with it.
Yeah, that's a tough shot.
I'm sure watching this, because it always looks like it's nothing in the camera, it's a long way.
Yeah.
Well, here's what you're dealing with. Fog in the lenses.
Yeah.
We don't have illuminated reticles on these particular scopes. You got snow coming down, so you're trying to pick out the target. By the way, we do have an excuse cone right over there. Show the light on it, dude. There it is. See, told you. And it's just different.
It is. There's a lot of factors. I mean, there's a lot to overcome. It really is. There's so many variables that you have to account for. And, you know, it's everything. It's dialing in the system, you know, the ammo, the scope, everything has to be dialed in to connect. And, you know, at these shorter ranges, you know, sure, you got a lot of light, you got illuminated reticles, and it makes it so much easier. But you start ranging out. You know, if you don't have illumination, if you don't have anti-fog and all the other stuff that, you know, compensates for all those things, it gets darn near impossible.
So. And you're cold.
And the cold.
And your hands are kind of cold too, right?
Yeah. Feeling the fingers, let alone feeling the trigger, gets pretty difficult
in
this kind of weather. So, yeah, a lot of obstacles to overcome. I'm sure it's doable, but, you know, it's not easy by any stretch. And I've got a lot of things to work on when I start building my own weapon system.
Here's what I want you to do. When you go home tonight or tomorrow morning, write down all the things you learned on this.
Yeah.
And it will help guide you. A lot of the things I've talked about on Tabletop, pretty much all of them actually.
Yeah.
But write them down. And then that's what guides your system.
Yeah.
But to me, having a gun like you're holding that gun right there, my SPR build, is built for what you're doing.
Yeah.
The only thing I don't have on that is the illuminated reticle because I didn't want to spend the money.
Mm-hmm.
Probably should have, but didn't.
Yeah.
But the scope, it'll still work as long as you can see the target.
Yeah. With enough light, you know, it helps out. And I mean, you know, it'd be great if you had a giant working spotlight sitting right on top of your target, but I don't think a whole lot of people are going to do that waiting for you to shoot them. So.
And I don't have a weapon light on that, which could work. I don't know.
Yeah.
But that's what got, and let me tell you, this is a tough night you're out on.
Ooh, tough.
This is not like a summer afternoon day. We're not shooting at the range in Ohio. We're not shooting from concrete. This is, and we ran you a mile before we had you shoot, and.
2 miles.
Huh?
At this point, we're like 2 miles.
Couple miles.
Yeah, 2.5, because we've done that back, and it's like 10, 12 degrees.
Yeah.
It was 20 when we started, and that was a couple hours ago.
That's true.
And that was when it was kind of light.
So you probably don't realize it, but we've talked about it in running guns. As you start out fresh and you're really doing a lot better like your first run.
Yeah.
But now your second run, you do it and you actually have a performance degradation.
Yeah.
So you may not even know it, but you do. And it takes, you can overcome it, but it takes a lot of mental concentration.
Yeah.
And competitors, if they train like this in these type of conditions, you can overcome it.
Right.
But you got to know yourself and know your gun. And, you know, we're just dumping you into a loner gun.
Oh, it's a lot better than what I brought.
Which was nothing.
Yeah. A loner gun and 5 minutes notice, too.
If you have an illuminated reticle in these conditions, it probably helps that. It does help that. It would help that. Yeah. I believe it helped that a lot. And then, it is so much darker. You know, we actually had some moonlight last time we were out here.
Well, and so, the flashlight died.
Out there, you can't see anything. Yeah, the flashlight's dead.
So you can't see the freaking target.
Right there. You can see a little bit of light out there on the hill.
Yeah, I'll see if I can zoom in for you guys. Here, hold this for a sec.
Okay.
Jay? Okay. I can't even see it. It's so freaking dim.
Well, I can, yeah, maybe not there. I mean, there's a little bit of light. And you get the crosshairs on there with no illumination, and they're so faint, they disappear quick.
So, you know, everybody's going to see this, and they're going to go, dude, I'm getting illuminated scope.
Well, you'd be smart. Hey, you'd be smart. There's no excuse not to. You get picked.
Well, if you want to be an all-night, all-weather shooter,
you're going to need it.
Do it. And that's a medium-quality scope on that SPR. It's not the highest quality. I like it. To save money, I didn't go illumination on that build.
What is Pro Staff?
It works. Yeah. But like he's found out tonight, Sean, without illumination, it's real easy to lose it, right?
You need to have a lot of light on your target or in the scope, because it's without light, you're not going to hit anything. It's a totally ineffective system without proper lighting. So, yeah.
At night.
And the other thing, night, too, yeah. like I was showing you earlier on my AR-15, that's only a full-power optic. Yeah. It wouldn't be enough for the 400, I don't think. I think you'd be better served with a higher power optic. You know, 3x9, probably minimum.
I agree. That's what I talk about all the time. What about, Sean, what would you think after going through what you went through tonight? Guys say all you need is a 1-4 power.
Not for these ranges. I mean, sure you could hit, but it's, you know, you're going to be much quicker and you're going to hit a lot more if you've got better magnification. I mean, it's the difference between looking through the scope and trying to hit this little dot, or looking through the scope and now you've got, you know, a quarter
okay.
of the...
Okay. What do you guys think? You already said it. You want a 3-9 at least, right? That's a 3-12, I think, isn't it? I love that range.
Yep, 3-12, not illuminated.
It's a Pro Staff 7. And notice on this gun, I've got all my zeros marked, which helped us out because that other stag, it was a loner and it didn't have the zeros marked. And so we kind of had to transition this one so we knew where we were at. So if you had to go to war with any of the guns you went shot tonight, which one would you choose?
Oh, I would take that one.
Yeah, me too.
Any day.
I hear you, brother.
Nice.
Yeah. I think the Kel-Tec, man. People aren't giving it credit.
Kel-Tec. I love the Kel-Tec. But I
ran good.
Cheap, light.
No
really
malfunctions.
Reliable.
That one had one jam, and we're attributing it to kind of underpowered ammo, which we've seen tonight. It's cold, the action's stiff, you need full power. I could have adjusted the gas block on that, and it does have an adjustment right there. But that's yet another project. More time.
Among the many, right?
We already had Sean waiting. How long do we have you waiting? Like an hour and a half before you ran?
I don't know. I lost track of time at 60th pace back and forth up and down the road.
We thought the coyotes were getting
it. Notice that target, how you have the contrast of the flashlight working?
Yeah.
That's a world of difference, right?
It is.
So look at this target, like Team Pierce. I mean, that totally hittable.
Yep.
Compared to if the flashlight dims or it goes out, good luck.
Yeah, you're going to need to send a flare to illuminate the enemy over there.
Are you happy with your cardio levels?
No, I'm not happy with them at all. I would like to be in much better shape, but it's, you know, time. You gotta allocate the time, and it is worth it. I mean, it's, you know, I do what little I can, but I really want to pick it up more.
Yeah, I think, probably not Jardine, but I wouldn't mind losing 10 pounds myself.
Yeah.
The problem is I like eating good food.
Yeah. Especially around the holidays.
And we're part-time shooters. Guys may watch this and go, oh, they're doing this all the time. Yeah. Not really.
No.
Once in a great while, we'll come out and do this.
Yeah. Weekend warriors. Yeah. There's a lot of demands on your time. You know, everybody's got family, work. You know, you got to be able to pay for the ammunition that you're going to be shooting. So, you know, you got to just get it in when you can.
Does your wife know you're out here?
She does.
What did she think about you coming out here tonight? Did you think it was crazy? Don't hold back.
No, she knows. I she follows the project with me enough through my stories that she knows that, you know, you never know what to expect out here. So she said she knew that, you know, once Nothing Fancy called, all bets are off. You know, I don't know what's going on. We're just going to get out and do it.
Huge kudos that you dropped whatever you had going and you came out, right?
Yeah. Hey,
Unlike that other dude.
Better than our first guy. He missed out.
Yeah, he did.
He missed out.
You did pretty good, dude. For coming out here, I thought all your short range was right on the money. I mean, you missed a couple, but the long range is tough.
Yeah.
It's rough, and we're not gonna fault you for this long range. It's just really a difficult night.
You shot it good with the AK too. That was a wrench thrown in. The AK was, I was impressed. The
iron sights.
Iron sights. About what was that? 100 yards?
About 70.
70 yards.
Yeah.
We're out here a week ago in the nice weather, and as we're packing it up, he said, "Dude, I would love to take somebody out here with a dusting of snow." And look what we got. Freezing temps. I mean, there's not a lot of snow out here, but boy, it's enough. It's enough to make it cold.
That's right.
Awesome. The ground's hard, which is...
I literally think my camera's freezing. I can see it either it's a viewfinder or something. It's shutting down.
It's not picking up the frozen snow.
All right, guys. Check out the moon, by the way. This is a Soldier Boy drill. And this is Sean, the TMPer. He's been following for 8 years. We knocked on his door uninvited. He has told me for years, begged me for years to come shoot with me. Yes or no?
Absolutely.
And you got your nightmare come true.
Yeah. No, it was a great time.
He held up to it, though.
Oh, it was a great time.
Yeah, dude, anytime I'll come and shoot.
I honestly think we owe you a daytime shoot sometime to make up for it.
Anytime.
Because if you come out, I haven't heard a single complaint from you all night. Have you?
No, not one.
Or Jardine, I haven't heard you complain either.
I do love it. Like I've said before, I would say Sean is probably saying the same thing. This is every TMPer's dream to get a chance, even in this. This is awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. So yeah, anytime. I'll come out anytime.
I appreciate it. I myself have learned even more coming out tonight. What works, what doesn't. For instance, use freaking full power ammo in everything when it's this cold. Don't go reduce power, and it's going to be expensive. Just is.
For those 77 grainers out of this, curious. Okay.
Yeah.
I hear them schwacking the steel a lot harder.
Big difference, isn't it?
Big difference.
Yeah, I love 77s.
Yeah.
And guys like, well, I need a 6.8 or a 300. I'm pretty happy with 77s out of an AR.
Yeah.
It's a whole different ball game.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to wrap it up. We have about an hour and a half of cleaning up steel. We're going to have to probably... thaw out Sean and ourselves. This is a Soldier Boy drill. So go up to PFI's store, Layton, Utah. Fill out the forms, apply if you're interested. You'll have to be in the Salt Lake Valley. No, we're not coming to your state and doing it. It is a huge logistical nightmare to run this. We've been working on it for a month, getting it ready. A month. And dude, be careful what you ask for. We may wake you up at 5 in the morning.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're laughing now. They won't be laughing when we knock. You're gonna get a dose of reality out here, right, guys?
Big dose. Once and we'll run us some snowshoes.
Signing off. Nothing Fancy Project. Happy holidays.
Good job.
Christmassy.
Good job.
All right.